Well, thank you very much. And I want to tell you, it is great to look across this room, a place where I've presided over emerging issues forums and a lot of other meetings over the years, to see all the people here tonight who are champions, every one of you, champions for public education. We are here tonight and we're talking about this great honoree and her work. But you are working. I know a lot of you. In my day, I knew all of you. But you're wonderful leaders for our schools and our children and our future. And folks, I know we've had some tough times in some ways, but I want to tell you, the supporters for public education are coming back in North Carolina. We're on our way. We're going a long way. And you all are doing it. And how appropriate it is that we're here tonight to honor and to tell the story of this great woman, this great leader, who has done so much for all of us. And you've heard those stories. Listen to this young lady here. Wasn't that amazing to hear her talk about her life and how it's been changed and the Goodnight scholarship? And this great president of the University of North Carolina. Let me tell you something. I know a lot about college presidents. We've got one of the best in all of America. Thank goodness for you, Margaret Spellings. We're thrilled you're in North Carolina. And don't you ever go back to Texas. Well, in a way, Anne Goodnight's story is a North Carolina story. She was born and raised here. She's the daughter and granddaughter of public servants. She went off to college to Meredith first and then to NC State and met the love of her life. And they got married, and together they've been working to build a great company and to build a great community and to build a great state. They raised a beautiful family. So our children went to school with them and their children. And they have a wonderful family, their children and their spouses. And of course, we all know about SAS, and we all know about Dr. Goodnight. And of course, Ann's was Jim's most important partner as he built this great company that I tell the story of everywhere I go. The largest privately held software company in the world. One that's admired around the world. And I want to tell you, it's not only a great company technologically and in every other way, but it is regularly voted as the best place for employees to work. Best company in the world. That tells you something about how they feel about education and helping people. Thankfully for North Carolina, Anne, who plays an official role directing SAS's philanthropic endeavors, as well as the family's charitable work, those children of theirs and those that they've helped chose education as their interest. And Anne has made her life about education and a few other things I'll mention before I finish. I don't know where North Carolina would be if it weren't for Anne Goodnight. I started in government a pretty long time ago, some of you know. I know what it was like. The first day after I was elected, I went down to the library in the governor's mansion, and I looked up the inaugural addresses of all the former governors, and I read every one of them. I wanted to see what the history was. And Terry Sanford had said, when he was elected, and you know what a great education governor he was, he said that at the time he was elected, only half of North Carolina's children graduated from school. Now, not many of you here tonight knew that, but you know it now. And I say that to you simply to point out that over the years we've made a lot of progress, but of course we still have a long way to go. SAS is a powerhouse, as you know, and all of us are very proud of that company that Ann has led in the field of education. And Jim is such a great leader. He is, of course, head of the Business Roundtable, and they're working education all over America. What a great team and partners they are for our state. Ann has been involved at every step of the way. I remember when I was first governor, and when we focused on children who couldn't read, I had run for governor, hearing that a lot of children reached the third grade and couldn't read. And I couldn't believe it. And I was furious about it. So I ran on the platform of making sure that every child learned to read by the third grade. And we put in classroom assistance, teacher assistance. Some of you remember that. I regularly hear people say, well, my mama was one of them. Thank goodness for her and for all of the people who got involved then, because we made a big step. We saw the need. We took the action to do something about it, and we put the resources in. That didn't come cheap. Every time we made steps in education, the Goodnights have been there. I remember when we started Smart Start, when we raised teacher pay to the national average. We went from 44th in the country to 20th in 4 years. It can be done if we want it done and the legislature will act. We have money. But what you need to know is, it was fine for us in politics to say something about it. It was good for others to take stands. You had to have the business community behind it. You had to have the recognized leaders in North Carolina that the legislature would listen to and we would all respond to. And we had it in Ann Goodnight and Jim and Sass. Thank goodness for them and all that they've done for early childhood education, for the early grades, the middle grades, high school, community colleges, higher education. You heard this young woman talk tonight, and you know what this can do for human beings. Folks, I want to tell you, not often we talk about education is important economically. It's true. Let me tell you something else. It is important morally. Now, I heard that preacher at the royal wedding the other day talk about love. Did y'all hear him? I knew he'd be here, by the way. I knew what he was like. But it's true. And education is a moral issue. If we love people and if we love God, we should help our fellow man. And we should help children have a good education and a great future, and they can be helped. The Goodnights believe that. They've done more than believe it and talk about it. They've done something about it. Ann Goodnight has been out there on the front lines. I will never forget. I will never forget the time when here in Wake County, and Wake County's gone a long way in improving its schools, but it hadn't always been there. And I remember one time we had a big bond issue on the ballot. And by the way now, if you believe in education, you gotta get out and work about it, work on it. Now, I don't like these people just go around and talk in highfalutin terms about how nice it is and how important it is and so forth. I want to see you work. I want to see you work for people who will support education in both parties. It ought to be a bipartisan issue, and it can be. But we had that bond issue on the ballot in Wake County. We thought it was going pretty good. And then all of a sudden, I think it was the Sunday before Election Day, maybe a week out, the Raleigh News Observer came out with a Sunday paper and an article that said that bond issue might very well fail. And we were shocked. And you know who pitched in to do something about it? Ann Goodnight and Jim and Sass. And we passed that bond issue in Wake County. And we can do those things all over North Carolina. But you gotta have great leaders. That was not an easy thing to do. It was courageous. It was kind of risky. They did it. Ann Goodnight is such a marvelous leader. And I am so grateful to her. Every time I've worked with her, and I've worked with her on so many things, I've always just felt like I was honored to be a friend, to be a co-worker, and to learn from her, as we all have. It is so appropriate that we honor her tonight. But let me tell you something. Ann Goodnight has done more than just lead on education. Do any of you know much about our great Museum of Art here in Raleigh, North Carolina? Do you know why it's a great Museum of Art with some of the best art in America and throughout the world? It's because of the Goodnights. I know we've got that museum. I helped with it. They did a lot of it. I rode an airplane one time with Ann going. I was going to New York City on something on education. I thought she was going to education, but she was going up there to buy art. I guess it was Jim's deep pockets or their deep pockets. Anyhow, she brought the art home. Thank goodness. It's ours in North Carolina. And we're so thankful and so proud. So folks, we've got a lady here tonight that is a marvelous, caring leader. The opposite of being big-headed, you know, stuffed up with her own importance. They could be that way. A lot of people get that way when they have wealth. Ann Goodnight thinks like the average people she came from in rural North Carolina. She thinks about those people. I live on a farm. I live with a lot of poor people. I grew up with them. Those are the kind of people, among others, that she's helped all of her life. North Carolina would not be the state it is today, nor have the future that we have out in front of us, if we do the right things, without Ann Goodnight. And all of us that come here tonight, sitting at these tables, all dressed up, all excited, and thank goodness for these wonderful daughters who are leading this work. We're here to honor Ann Goodnight. Ann, thank you. We know you've had so many honors, but you've done so much, and you stay at it. Every time I turn around, you're doing something more. With Jim and with all of the resources you all have and the people that you inspire. So tonight I want to thank her. I want to honor her. And while I'm not governor anymore, I shall take the opportunity to declare that Ann Goodnight is North Carolina's number one citizen and leader for education for all time to come. Ann, thank you.